appreciation of this. I think if you just went into this without reading the book, it's maybe a little limited. It doesn't really develop the stories as well as the novel does, but that's difficult anyway. So I would probably say if you loved the book already, this would be really great for you. Next up, no surprise if you've seen my videos before. Of that book. Is she evil? Yeah, I love stuff like this, like a grim sleeping sickness. It's cool. The artwork in here is very vibrant. It's a lot more like comic booky than the other ones I've shown you. I'm actually nervous flipping through this because there's some quite gory stuff in it, so I don't think we'll get to it just yet. But you see what I mean with the way that it's set out like a comic book more so than the other ones, kind of. It's very booksy. Some of it's super, super cool. And I'd still very highly recommend. Yeah, I greatly enjoyed this. I think I read it all in one sitting. I mean, it's not very big, but it's one of those ones you just kind of plow through because it's so exciting. Next up is in graphic novel form. I really, really enjoyed this. So Caroline, which is this young girl, has moved into a new house and her mum and dad are kind of ignoring her. She's really bored. They're just busy. She's on school holidays. And then she finds this door that leads to kind of an upside down version of our world. Everything's similar, but it's not quite the same. It's like a creepy version or a strange version of reality. And it's there that she meets the other mother, who looks like Caroline's mum, but is trying to keep her in this other world. And she gets scarier and scarier physically and mentally as time goes. Tale written by Margaret. So